Everybody, it's Invicta, and happy Thanksgiving Mosh Pit out there. I hope your days are filled with family, friends, and good food. And for those of you who don't celebrate Thanksgiving, I just hope you're having a great start to your day. Of course, Thanksgiving is my favorite holiday, so I'm sure that by the time this video goes out, I'm either on the way to dinner or we're just getting ready to eat. So we have lots of food, and I am very excited. And I hope that your days are going off great as well. Thank you very much for being here and spending the holiday with me. Hopefully, we have a heaping helping of Isaac today. We'll see. Here's your meme of the day brought to you here by Bridget Blitz. Title thread was, it scares us all. I fear no man, but that thing scares me. I can't do a good heavy accent. I can't do a good accent in general. Thank you very much, Bridget Blitz, and everyone who upvoted that one. Let's see if we got some heaping helpings of damage and all kinds of good stuff today. C-Day is going to be 8. Mike Zulu Papa, 3 Zulu Mike Whiskey. Lots of Zulus, lots of Mikes. We're starting off with a Hierophant card along with Curse of the Blind here, of course, but we are starting off with good stats anyway, except our movement speed, 0.95 is great, 3.41, or 0.95 is not great, 3.41 is great, however, as well as our damage, 3.57 is just And also start off with Aquarius here. Aquarius is a very good item that we've learned a lot about recently, and it is a very strong item that has lots of very good synergies, especially if you end up getting homing or something like that. Aquarius ain't bad, y'all. On the flip side, because it's on theme, right? Because today, of course, is Thanksgiving. We've got ourselves the meat cleaver. It's carving time, baby. Take a little bit of damage there from the Diglett. We don't care about that. Now, obviously, this is great because we are also getting a Hierophant for the start here, which means that we are going to be able to have those elusive soul hearts that we need on the first floor. Oh, my. What the heck is going on over here? What are y'all doing over here? This is just a champion. This is just a champion smorgasbord of champions, but somehow that did not hit the Tinted Rock. I don't know what's going on over here, man. There we go. All right. That was a weird cluster. For some reason, I don't know how that didn't hit. Dude, we're just getting lit up, like, by everything, every which way, shape, or form here. I don't know how that first nub didn't hit that Tinted Rock, but then the second one did. It was even further away from the rock. It's very weird. Like a double champion Lime Horn here in a very, very odd first floor. I thought that one would hit it. So as you see here, the cleaver is going to basically split all enemies in half, and essentially what it's going to do is it's going to make multiple copies of the enemy. Oh my god, we're getting soul hearts and we got a tears upgrade. What in the world? Sure, we'll throw it on the Hierophant card. Wow, ton of HP, man. Curse of the Maze. But yeah, so the meat cleaver is basically going to, it's going to cut everything in half and make them half as, they basically cuts their HP in half, essentially, is what it does. Puts them in two smaller versions with less health, essentially. Now it's not a full on 50% damage or 50% health reduction. It just makes them have less health. But if you have a high enough damage, it is very good and very effective at killing things. Now, one of course the neatest tricks that you can do with the meat cleaver is you can actually use it 7 times against Delirium and it will automatically kill him, which is nice. It's very, very good. I don't know how far you can go with the cleaving on regular enemies, but as you see here, it makes them much easier to deal with. Yes, you do have to be careful about the extra projectiles from like mini stros and that sort of thing, but it only takes 1 or 2 hits to bring them down as opposed to like 4 or 5. So it is still a very good item for AoEing and that sort of thing, even though it doesn't do direct damage to anything. I would warn against using it against Claudies, because Claudies actually are kind of a little bit dangerous. But mini Shros, I mean, anything that makes them less tanky is fine by me. A Bursting Sack here. Bursting Sack is going to give us a spider every now and then. Petrified Poop is going to be good here. Petrified Poop is going to also increase the amount or the likelihood of us actually getting something out of a poop pile, which early on, poop piles are very ubiquitous throughout the early levels. So, you know, that's a very good source of early game consumables and pickups and that sort of stuff, and money as well. Or I'm all about that. Again, with this damage that we've got here, 3.5. 5.7 now with 4.36 tier delay. I mean, we're looking real solid. Oh, Duke. There we go. Just, hey, you see how easy Duke went down there. I mean, and Duke is not a tanky mob by any means, but it is nice just to be able to bring him down like a lot faster. He is going to obviously spawn more flies, but it's not really that big of a deal. Three not great trinkets there, and okie dokie. Well, could go angel deals if we want to. I mean, we're saving all items or angel deals for next week for sure. Obviously, we do want twisted pair, so I'm going to go twisted pair here. We can actually afford everything. We really wanted them. I think I'll hold off. Actually, no, we can't afford everything. We could have, but I did it a little bit out of order. But I don't really want duality right now anyway. I feel like, you know, yesterday's run, it was a disappointment on a few levels for some people, including myself, really. You know, I'd expect a lot more out of a devil deal run only run. But as I said towards the end of yesterday's episode, I do feel like we were getting the short end of the stick in terms of like the actual quality of items were concerned. So, you know, today is Satan's redemption, and what a holiday to celebrate it on, with it being Thanksgiving, you know. I mean, it's not a religious holiday, at least not that I think of anyway. Yeah, coupon. Now, with us having Nun's Habit and the Cleaver is actually a very interesting combo, because if we end up getting enough HP, we could potentially use the Cleaver more times than would be usually expected. You can use it more than once in a room, which is great because, again, as I was talking about versus Delirium, it can be used offensively if you have enough ways to trigger it. Twisted Pair is going to give us familiars here to see us take a hit from the Wharf there, or the Gaper, I should say. Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to get into the library as much as I would love to. Oh, my goodness. Just a random Eternal Heart showing up. Take that. Secret Room might be here. It is. We get Necronomicon. Again, kind of speaks volumes to us. I'd rather go with Necronomicon, especially with Nun's Habit. I know we just got done talking about the Cleaver, but the Cleaver, the downside is that, you know, it doesn't deal direct damage. Even when we're talking about Delirium, it doesn't deal direct damage to him. It only splits him up. So, you know, it's a good item, but it's not that good. At least Necronomicon, there's no subtleties around it. It's simply you just use it and then it just deals damage. That's it. So no nuance there. You just use it, AoE damage, and you're Gucci. Yeah, man. I hope. I mean, at this time, like right now, at the time of this video releasing, we're probably not eating dinner yet. Mama Victa doesn't make dinner that early. But I'm probably over there watching football, that's for sure. You know, there's something about Thanksgiving. I don't know why. It's just, maybe it's just the smell of the home cooking, plus, like, you know, it's colder outside usually anyway. This year it's not super cold, but I don't want it to be super cold. Also, I'm really upset that we got hit by that shot all the way up there. There's no excuse for that. Just the time of the year, the weather, and just the smell of turkey and rolls in the oven and having like the pies and stuff. All that stuff is just, it's a good feeling, you know. I don't know if it's holiday cheer, because to me that feels like you can't really say that until it's Christmas time. And, you know, and of course everyone knows that you've at least got one or two neighbors that have already like set out all their Christmas decorations. It's like, okay, all right, settle down there, Chief. It ain't even December yet, but, you know, here we are. Dip's kind of running a little interference for us. I appreciate that. EFF is going to absolutely help us out hugely with Twisted Pair. There's nothing in here. Okay. I think I should have gotten that other host. It looked like it didn't close in time. Unfortunately, we're not going to get any help here in terms of damage or really anything. I do wish, and this is something that, Ed would never do, or Vin. I mean, neither one of them are going to even consider this, but if it were up to me, I wish that if you did draw a boss that had a static drop, like, say, Cuban Meat or, you know, Gish or Chad or anything like that, I wish the game would automatically just give you a second option for an item, but that would just be too much power. You know, sure, give the option to the player if they want the orbital and they've got something like BFF or Nod Leaf or something like that, then hey, that's great. More power to you. But, you know, if not, then you know, I'd like to have something a little bit better than a cube of meat. You know, take a look at Soulstone Survivors, a game that we just played this week. And, you know, it's just, there's so many customization options for your build. And you could even switch your build halfway through the run if you needed to or wanted to, you know. And if you don't want to, swap out any of the active items or passives that you have, then hey, you know what? You can say, hey, game, give me nothing but passives, and you have the freedom of doing that. That's the kind of stuff that I'd like to see more of in Isaac. But again, we're never gonna see stuff like that. Never say never, but I'm saying never. I don't think we're going to get an actual choose your adventure roguelite mode for Isaac. Would be nice. Definitely would. The judgment card here, which we don't really care about. Still let the Necronomicon do its thing here. Unfortunately, we don't have any Yaves. Bursting Sack giving us some friendly spiders, and we appreciate that. Okay, so at least we can bomb our way into the item room here. That saves us one key that we need. Obviously, I'd love to get into the planetarium. Not sure why we got a planetarium, but hey, we'll take it. Almost bombed my way up here. That would have made me very mad. But that would have been very on brand for me as well. Having football as well. I remember back in the day, one of my favorite memories was when the Xbox, the original Xbox first came out. I don't know how long ago that was at this point. But it was during I was able to get it early. Funny game. I was able to get it early, and I remember playing the Xbox basically like nonstop over the holidays, and just having that, like, you sit down and you're playing video games, it's cold outside, you're in your pajamas, and, like, you know, like, dad's sitting, he's sitting on the recliner reading his paper or whatever, and, you know, and you're, it's just cold, and but you got the fire going. It's that warm feeling that I get every time we get around this time of the year, that I'm like, this is my happy place, I think. Still do not have a single key. A Steam overlay. What are you doing on the? You're supposed to be disabled. Screen overlay. Steam screen overlay. Not sure what the heck you're doing here. Okay, we need to get a. Okay. All right, game.
Judgment.
And a demon judgment to kick it all off. All right. So we are going to be completely denied of getting into a planetarium and a shop because we don't have any keys. So that's fun. Double champion Polycephalus here. No double deal. Could be a bombs or key. Not, of course it's a tears down. Why would it be anything else other than that, you idiot? Woo! Happy Thanksgiving. Heaping helping of just goodness with Isaac. Trying to see if we can get a chest. Oh, we're doing it. Of course it's a red chest and it's Guppy's tail. It's just hilarious, game. You are absolutely hilarious. Game's got jokes. Game has got jokes. Well, I hope that you all are laughing and happy and having a great time, because Lord knows I am. Could actually tap again, but only once, basically. Actually, no, we can't. We can't because it would basically just give us a... It would just give us the Angel Deal blessing, and that's it. And we don't care about that. The chest was our only option that we could have gotten. The key from, anyway. Demon Judgment's not going to pay out with a key, but it might give us an item. If it gives us a Guppy item, then I'm going to be forced to take Guppy's Tail, which I really don't want to do because of our aforementioned key problems, but here we are. Ears down. One pill. What effect? Don't ever take pills, anyone. Don't ever take pills. Pills are not worth it. Ever. 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 Either Demon Judgments. They're just never worth it. Say what you will about pills and, you know, playing too safe and all that stuff. There's a reason why this playstyle has evolved the way to the way it is now. Isaac is not a game where if you gamble, you win. Pills are a gamble. Don't let anyone ever tell you anything differently. If you have PhD, if you have Virgo, sure. Go for it. Or Luckfoot, you know, that's fine. It's less of a gamble then, because at least you can't lose anything. That's the whole problem when it comes to pills and blind items and all that stuff. It's not a game that you're rewarded for gambling on. So now, of course, we're flush with keys. We don't need them anymore, and they're no longer relevant. It's not to that floor anyway. Now I have to do the painstaking job of trying to get back our tiers rate towards the mid-game stages. The secrets. We could take the Book of Sin as well. I take Book of Secrets for mapping. Mapping extremely important. Did pick up the Golden Horseshoe as well. The Golden Horseshoe is going to give us a small chance. It's not a good chance, but a small chance of getting a double item room. I haven't seen the Golden Horseshoe pay out in a very long time. You have to stay above Bloat here until you absolutely can't anymore, because he will cause Brimstone to go every which way, and we failed a 68% Devil Deal. All right. That, of course, you know, we did get our tiers rate back, but it's still apology not accepted though. We need to get some damage associated with our run here as well. The only damage upgrade that we've gotten so far was the Sinvicta robes, which is good. It's good. Don't get me wrong, but it's not a we're just set for the entire run sort of good. In the curse room, because I mean, hell, why not? And we can at least go check out what's inside of our boss trap room here. BFF Twisted Pair trying to do the best that they can. See if we can make the mom hand land on the skull. We do. Seeing that the spiders are actually friendly is because of Bursting Sack. Save ourselves a key here as well. I don't actually want to get the Soul Heart yet. As crazy as it may seem, it's because we want to actually go into the boss trap room to see what's in there, because it's almost going to always going to be at least an HP upgrade or better. Almost always, not always. But before we do that, we need to go fight Boss Rush, because we just need to get some kind of good damage item going here. See the egglets, they don't actually hurt us here. We're gonna make Boss Rush pretty easily. Just a little snipe there with the EFF cube of meat. This is definitely a binge eater worthy run if we end up getting it. Right now, I don't know, man. I'm not 100% confident that in our ability to win this run right now. I will take. Actually, no, we can't take Succubus. Never mind. I can only take Purgatory if I wanted to. Purgatory ain't bad. We know that we're gonna be getting. Yeah, we gotta go Polaroid here. We know that we are going to be getting. I honestly don't think the Tiny Planet helps us. I don't think any of these help us right now. We know that we're going to be at least getting possibly an HP upgrade in here, which of course it's a tiers upgrade. Tiers up in shot speed, both of which we don't actually need currently. There's a sack room here. Purgatory is still going to be good. I believe, I could be wrong, I believe that BFF affects Purgatory, I think. But even if it doesn't, it's still a good item to have. Very good for, obviously, for projections, or for projectile clearing, not projections. This isn't Inception or anything here. We're just talking about projectiles. Take the swarm. Swarm's good for a little bit of defense, which is obviously what we need here. And we're on a low life spree right now. I'd have to be careful going into the womb. Gonna draw that. We could take the dull razor as well, but gonna choose not to. Because, I mean, we have no real interaction with dull razor. Get a soul heart. We did swallow the petrified poop. Some marbles. Got a penny. I'll put this back in here, so. We're making good time, but it's not a good time. That makes sense. Augatory, bam. That's good damage there, so. All right. Gonna have to be careful. Your super secret room might be there. It is. Don't get Guppy's head. But I'm still gonna stick with the Book of Secrets because navigation is gonna be crucial here. So we didn't get the map effect, but we did get the compass effect, and that's good enough. It just shows us the general right direction we need to go to. I know it may seem slightly insane here that we're prioritizing mapping above damage, above flies, but this is a case where this is not a run where you can be safe at. This isn't a run where we can safely be just taking every single wrong way that we could possibly go. This is going to be a run that's won by dodging and going the right way, essentially, and getting lucky. Devil deals don't even really matter at this point because we can't afford to take any. See, we lack the burst damage that we need to effectively take down even Globins right now. There we go. Purgatory doing a good job. Clearing the way for us a little bit. Really hoping that Petrified Poop comes through with us and for us and gives us an An Eternal Heart or a Soul Heart. Either one would be fine. Definitely want the Locust of Famine here. I mean, Mr. Fred should be a fairly easy fight. Even with low stats, Mr. Fred doesn't really represent a big threat. More of his adds than anything. Especially with us having the Swarm here for defense. Don't care about his add. We can take care of it whenever it's dead. We do get movement speed as well as a damage upgrade, thankfully, and a strength card that we can use in emergencies. Okay, all right, we're surviving. We do be surviving. This time we did get the map effect. So, only one way to go anyway. We know that the heart's probably going to be in the upper left-hand corner. A chariot card wouldn't be bad either. The chariot card actually makes more sense than the strength card, mainly because of the fact that we have BFF and Cuban meat, even though I just dogged all over it. On the second or third floor, or third floor whenever we got it. Thank you for Navi. Chest giving us a key here. Constitutes one of those Victa doesn't feel like clearing it rooms. Yeah, so right there, I mean, we were able to just supercharge our navigation straight to the boss. Look how many rooms that we skipped and didn't have to clear through because we knew where we were going to be going, or at least had a very good approximation where we were going to be going. That is so massive. Which is why I prioritize mapping so much. So much. This is not a strawman argument. This isn't a new revelation for those of you who've watched me a while. You know how much I value mapping and navigation, and this is the reason why. For runs like this, where we're not necessarily on death's row yet, but we very well could be if we take a wrong turn. 68% deal with the devil failure. Again, not that we could have taken it anyway. And, you know, It's not a I told you so. This is the reason why I do that. We were able to fast track our way over to our way over to the boss. And we're much safer for it too. No stress at all over that. Don't need goat hoof. See, we were going in the wrong direction, but now we know which way is the right direction. We can fully skip this 2x2 room down here by going one room over, playing this one with relative ease, and then we could bomb our way through this one here, because obviously say that, and then we 2.0 movement speed our way into a skull. But again, staying safe with half of a heart. It involves going the right way, and you know, one less room for us to clear is one less room that we can take damage in. Although ironically, we took damage in the room that I was trying to skip anyway, because you know, of course. Did he just shoot without actually shooting? Baby Bender ain't bad. Baby Bender is going to give Twisted Pear a Spoon Bender effect. All we got to do is just play perfect through the chest and through Isaac. No big deal. Done it before. We'll do it again. Still have the Chariot card to help us in case if we do get in trouble. I'm not anticipating against Isaac anyway. Got to get him through this phase here. Nice slowing shot. Ag Purgatory. One more crack the skizzle. All right. Make you a little chest, but we don't need it. All right. Let's see if the wait was worth it. No. 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 And no. All right. All righty. Tom's Eyeshadow. Angry Fly and Giant Cell. Sure, why not? This. Blue Baby can't spawn in a skinny room, so I guess it's to the south? Honestly, not sure. You calm it down there, Angry Fly. Sharp Straw ain't bad. The Tinted Rock over here, which I'm just going to go ahead and go for immediately. Just to get us out of the danger zone. Got Navi. I'm going to assume it's to the southeast. The two damage ups is all we end up getting on this run, and it's going to be enough, but just barely. Assuming it's over here. And what we can do is we can use Chariot card. We don't need to use the Chariot card immediately, but we can use it in case we get in trouble. But Purgatory taking out all the projectiles and any projectiles that do get past it, being blocked by Swarm, we should be okay here. I know we do it all. Didn't even have to use it. GG! No problem at all. Who was scared? Not me. And you know we're going to do another run. I told you it's a heaping helping of Isaac, everyone. Let's freaking do it. Happy Thanksgiving. All right. Second run, 6 Hotel, 3-7, Kilo Hotel, Victor 9. Click that like button, I'd appreciate it. Starting off with Eye of Belial, horrible tears rate, good movement speed to start with, and decent damage. But Eye of Belial, of course, is going to be a very nice starter for us, along with Friend Ball, which is, Friend Ball ain't that great. I know that they've been trying to make Friend Ball better, but it's just not. It's too much micromanagement for not a lot of gain at all. In my opinion, anyway. Just toss there, Isaac. Playing lots of Scarlet and Violet, eh? Oh no, don't take my Friend Ball charge away, please. I'd rather have Remote Detonator than Friend Ball. Remote Detonator is going to give us 5 bombs, which is great. And we'll start off with Penny Sack as well, which is. It certainly is. It certainly is. Hey, at least we have a good amount of HP to start with here, although we did just lose our Devil Deal because, that's just how it be with a 2.04 tiers rate. Going to be a challenge to thrive here early on anyway, but Eye of Belial, of course, is going to give us a piercing shot that goes through its targets, and then if that tier hits anything after passing through its initial target, it's going to deal double damage and be homing. Not as strong as like a Sacred Heart home, but it's good enough. It's like a Godhead level of homing. And the damage is just great. I mean, piercing shots to start off a run with on an Eden run is just phenomenal. I can overlook losing our first Devil Deal. But this is the problem with starting with the first of the XL floor is just that, you are doing two floors at once essentially. So if you do get hit on floor one, you're getting hit on floor two as well, which means that you don't get a Devil Deal. Wow, are you kidding me? Glowing Hourglass is kind of. We can take the Glowing Hourglass, I guess. Since we haven't really seen any good uses for it yet. Now it did get changed in the recent patch, where it's only good for 3 uses on one floor, and that is it. Then it turns into the regular Hourglass until the next floor, essentially. So, if that sounds good to you, then sure. But Again, it's kind of one of those, like, why questions. Like, why bother changing an item that's always done the same thing forever? That's the key word of repentance, was just why. Why change this? Why did this need to be changed? Why did this go from here to here? Why did this change loot tables? That sort of thing. That's repentance in a nutshell. Advantageous for us for the dips to go in front of Dingle, especially if he's just going to sit there like an idiot. Because then our double damage tiers are going to be hitting, are going to be basically reaching him before our initial tiers, which is obviously going to be doing more damage. But piercing shots is one of the few times that I say it's okay to fire at a charging enemy. Normally, it's not a good idea. That shot turned around. I did a full 180. We are going to get a black soul heart here, so at least we have a small chance of getting into the devil deal, although it is unlikely. And we go from one run that had maxed out tiers to this, and that's rough. But we get a few chances here. Champion Yellow Champion Gurglings is a horrible matchup for us. Absolutely terrible matchup for us. We can take down one, then it gets easier. Yeah. One hit I can tolerate, not two. Didn't want to have to do this, but I'm gonna. So we did get a devil deal, obviously, and us getting backstabber with piercing shots is real good. Us getting backstabber is real nice with piercing shots, and we are also going to be able to get a Gimpy here, which is going to be great. Let's try to take our time now instead of acting like we're in like such a hurry, because we're not. There. All right. So let's take a step back and settle down here. It's Thanksgiving. No hurry. Of all the days that exist in the world of the year, this is not a time that we need to be rushing. There's no rushing needed on Thanksgiving. You got plenty of food. You got plenty of football. Chill out. We don't need to be taking bad damage walking through spikes and whatnot. Shout out to the Glowing Hourglass, of course. Now, one thing I will say, going back to talking about the change to Glowing Hourglass, it is nice that it doesn't require a full charge, which allowed us to do that just over and over again. So that is nice. Eventually, that is very good. But obviously, if you have any kind of self-charging mechanism, like, you know, Nun's Habit or Four and a Half Bowl or anything like that, then that's where the goodness ends and the badness arrives in terms of the change. But I think for the regular runs, Glowing Hourglass has a little bit more practical application just because it does not require a full charge, so you don't have to prepare to use it just in case if you need it, sort of a thing. Absolutely need Screw here. Screw's a big damage up for us. Gain one key for picking up the Gilded Key. Don't necessarily want to have all golden chests, but we'll hold on to it for now. See Backstabber do its thing here. Good. All right, good. We're able to get a tiers up. That's big for us. We can pay two bombs to get one. Okay. We get a golden key. All right, that's very good. Gonna go great for our gilded key now. To run that one in the fire. You should always go target the wall banger that has not fired or that has fired yet. All you gotta do is just size up the one that hasn't fired yet, and then go kill the one that has fired. Game, save us a bomb here. The damage upgrade here from Mom's Ring and a rune as well, which is going to be the Soul of Eden. Okay. Soul of Eden is going to reroll from all loot tables, including item pedestals and everything on the ground. We probably want to save this for that item room or maybe boss rush. But that's a long, long, long time to invest in one single reroll, which may not prove to be all that useful. So we I'll most likely just use this for teleport. This ain't good. Not good. May seem stupid to buy that bomb there, but we're really just doing we're just bombing the keeper just to raise our Devil Deal chance a little bit. So this is where piercing shots and backstab are just so good, especially with Eye of Belial, man. Eye of Belial is just get another tiers up here with Squeezy. That is huge as well. Now we're starting to cook. We get Abba Dabba Ding Dong, which is going to give us movement speed and damage. Huge gains on floor three here for us. Big time plays. Our damage is already better than it was on the first run. It will touch it for. I keep forgetting that Plum Flute actually does contribute to the Beelzebub transformation. And we can go in the curse room here. If there's nothing in here that we like, we just simply use the Glowing Hourglass out because it's essentially a free check, right? Should go to our. I believe this is going to go to our tiers as well. Yeah, that's a 0.5 tiers up. Yeah, we can't. Okay, we did get our soul heart back. That was a huge play going back in there. We can take pills if we really want to. This is one of the times where it is appropriate to take pills because. Obviously, if it's something bad, we just simply walk out, or we just simply use the glowing hourglass. So, use this to identify pills as well. One of the criticisms that I've faced since getting the glowing hourglass, I always forget to do that. Yeah. And that's why we don't take pills, kids. Two runs in a row, the first pill that we take, it tears down. As if you needed any more evidence. How does he do it? How does he do it? Definitely not worth the soul heart doing that. Grim should be here with our last bomb. Has a mega tears down. Get a charge key. Nose goblin's real good as well. Those goblin, especially with Eye of Belial, it's gonna apply the booger tears so much easier to targets, because Eye of Belial obviously is gonna have pass through, or piercing, but as well is that it's going to be homing, which increases the likelihood that we're gonna be attaching these booger tears to our targets more often than not. Love the shot speed. Yeah, we'll take Bird's Eye as well. Bird's Eye, of course, is going to give us the fire shot or flame shot, red candle shot, whatever you want to call it. I ain't losing a half soul heart because of that. The soul heart here, very good. A dead end. Moon card. We can use this for the boss rush. We are doing a very good job of staying ahead of. Mostly assisted by the fact that we did get an XL floor on floor one. But we also have like incredible utility here with our tier effects. Not incredible damage, but you know, with Eye of Belial, with the Nose Goblin, we're doing all right. We out here, I believe, is what the kids say. Got to stand toe to toe with Isaac or with Greed there. It's just the sound effect. The sound effect of the way that that backstabber just sounds, it puts so much more visceral feeling behind these shots. You know, in a Dead Cells-y sort of way. Makes it a much more satisfying item to use now. And backstabber's just good. Like, it's just legitimately good. Now, with the bleeding effect and things that move around, they're going to be taking more damage. Like, it's just good. It's just a very good tier effect. Super Secret Room might be here. We can use the Glowing Hourglass if it's not. And it's not. So we can get our bomb back. No big deal. As you see, it turns into the regular Hourglass now. And the regular Hourglass also does not receive a full charge should you use the Glowing Hourglass to completion. HP upgrade. Get on down. All right. Let's check out this dice room here. In the room, D20 with lots of keys in it. We actually don't need that many keys, so I'm going to grab two and then roll the rest. This just pays for the keys that we... oh, man. This just pays for the keys that we used to get in here. So that way there was no real risk for us there. It was just all profit. And look at this. We get, just in the nick of time here, Sigil Baphomet, which is going to give us that awesome damage shield. Arguably one of the best trinkets in the game. I mean, it's hard to really argue against it. You know, getting a damage shield every time you kill an enemy for a half second that basically stacks on itself. The faster that you kill, or the more things that you kill, the longer that the shield lasts. Now, originally, the Shield of Baphomet, when Repentance first came out, it actually stacked on itself infinitely. And that was obviously a problem, because if you had rooms like this, where if you had lots and lots and lots of mobs that spawned a ton of adds, you essentially could not be killed. So then they nerf it down to what it is now, which is just simply you get a maximum of, I think, 2 seconds. It's 2 or 3 seconds of invincibility if you can kill that fast. Hit a rock there. Unfortunately, we don't have any more bombas. Sigil Baphomet is just good. It is definitely what I would consider to be an elite tier item. Battery, which doesn't do anything for us. And we don't have any bombs, so we can't really take advantage of that Tinted Rock over here. Not that we really need it that much, of course. To be quite honest, even if it was Small Rock, it's not an automatic pickup right now. Our movement speed is not great. We're in no danger of losing the run right now, obviously, but still, you have to weigh the consequences of taking certain items. And Small Rock has been kind of on the bubble for me lately, anyway, with the may not take option. Red Gate, consistently one of my least favorite bosses, on top of Red Mega Maw. And another HP upgrade, which is a big disappointment. And we get Eye of a Cult, which is a good damage upgrade as well. So we could go into the Curse Room. We got plenty of time to make it to Boss Rush, as long as we don't lollygag. One bomb for a Soul Heart's a pretty good trade. Oh, not worth it. 7 cents and a red heart for half of a, or for an entire Soul Heart is just, it's, yeah, the bad deal. Bad deal. So very, very kind of meh floor here, but still getting XP for, or HP for it. Not XP. There's no XP in Isaac. Scorpio is going to be a fantastic poison upgrade for us. Combined with piercing shots here, giving us those poison tears is just... Polished bone, eh. Can definitely take our sweet time here going into the devil deal. Not devil deal, but boss rush. We don't even have to really teleport out if we don't want to. Get another HP upgrade. Yeah, sure. So notice how right there we did technically lose an HP, half of a soul heart walking out of there, but again, because we were able to get out of the door before the HP upgrade from lunch could take hold, we actually technically gain that soul heart back. This just pushes all of our hearts to the right one, essentially. Movement speed, one of those stats that you don't really think about too much unless you're lacking it. But I've been a major supporter of the idea that movement speed is one of the most important stats to have. Not the most important, but defensively, absolutely one of the most important stats to make sure that you're not lacking on. Get our fool card here. All right, very odd looking map. Now, if you do celebrate Thanksgiving, does your family do lots of desserts as well? I'm not talking about like pumpkin pie and apple pie. I'm saying like cookies, desserts, that sort of thing. Mama Victa goes pretty ham on the desserts. No pun intended there. I'm all for it. Betrayal's kind of eh. Pick up his eye and we get Libra. Libra, I feel like, would probably increase our tears rate by quite a bit. And it did. For minimal damage loss, too. Mama Victa goes. She goes pretty ham with the desserts. Sometimes we get we always get the standard pie. We always get the standard pumpkin pie and apple pie, and then we always get chocolate chip cookies. Those three are a staple. Sometimes if Mama Victa's feeling like it, we sometimes will receive banana pudding with our dinner. Good old banana pudding. I'm always down for banana pudding. Occasionally, Mom, she'll make like a, not a chocolate cake, but like a, she'll do like a, not German chocolate. Oh, yeah, German chocolate cake, which I'm not a big fan of. And that's usually the reason why she doesn't make them, is just because, like, you know, I just don't like them. There's something about German chocolate cakes that I'm just like, eh, but like at the same time, I'm not a big cake enjoyer either. Like, I don't particularly care for cake. I'm very happy with pumpkin pie. I'm very, very happy with apple pie. I actually prefer pumpkin pie a little bit more than apple pie. The German chocolate, I'm like, eh. It's got those weird, like, coconut bits in there or whatever it is that... Is it like that sort of pulp? You know what I'm talking about. German chocolate pulp. I was hoping they were going to get a sneaking angel item out of the sacrifice room. Didn't happen, but what can you do? No mapping here. We got to be a little bit careful. Obviously, we went... It was a little bit of a risk, but with this amount of damage, and especially with Sigil of Baphomet, there's not really that much of a risk to give up, you know, that many soul hearts. I was kind of hoping that we were going to get the soul heart payout as well. But obviously, Libra here, we take Libra for the huge tiers up, but also because of the practical application of our tier effects are going to be going out much faster and making us much stronger than we actually look like we are on paper with the stats anyway. Strength card. I mean, Tarot Cloth ain't really worth it unless there's a Hero Font card in here, which it wasn't. I'm going to go ahead and undo that. Not worth two soul hearts. And there are shot speed getting to the doppelganger before it even had time to really react. So there's your entire map. Now that we've gone through our full clear quota for the day. Sigil of Baphomet being super helpful right now. The Sigil of Baphomet allows you to go toe-to-toe with enemies without fear of actually getting nailed by one of their shots. As long as you're killing things, you can just sit there and be like, yeah, so you have a death rattle that shoots a shot right towards me. So what? What of it? I got a 2-second damage shield, bro. I'm fine. All right. Going Hourglass helping us out again. Hey, you know, maybe the glowing hourglass change isn't that big of a deal with some people. Like I said, you're gonna feel the change for the worse if you're used to having broken runs that have like unlimited charges on the glowing hourglass or just make you totally immortal. But in a run like this, where like we're not really needing it all that much, like you're barely gonna notice the difference. And like I said, it is very nice that you can at least have the ability to use it without having to charge it. Big room might be here. It is. Sometimes it's on the right side of this room. It really depends on what's adjacent to it. That the backstabbing or backstabber effect taking a hold of that host before he even got away. Go check to see inside of this here curse room if it was worth it. Gubby's collar gives us an extra life. Sack dagger doesn't, but the thing is that Bloody Gust does give us extra. It gives us extra stats when we take damage. It's an all stats up when we take damage. Now, was that worth going down to two soul hearts for? I don't know. It's debatable. Really, the correct play there was not going into the devil deal unless we miss it. Now, us keeping that bone heart was obviously ideal because, you know, that counts as a red heart container. So we could have taken that. We could take that one heart devil deal for the cost of an empty bone heart, which is not that big of a deal. This is one of those times where the shield is just going to last forever. Bit of a tricky dodge over there. Thank God the vortex turrets don't curve the brimstone shots from the red blorbs. Okay, it's important to dispatch the eye lasers in here quickly. That way we start off, we can immediately bum rush the other eye over there. Start off with the shield and then just go ham and turkey on a Thanksgiving taco ham bone here on Mom's Heart. There we go. And we did get the Devil Dioso. That was a misplay, unfortunately. But it is what it is. Hindsight's always going to be 20/20. You know, not going into the Devil Deal, not using our hearts until after seeing if we were going to make it was all the difference. Because what happens then is that if we know that we're not going to make it into the Devil Deal, since we've already failed our Devil Deal spot, what happens then is that we can go back into the curse room and then prepare a little bit better for which ones are we going to need. Instead of having to go through an entire level with, you know, 2 HP on it. So it didn't affect us. At the end of the day, it didn't affect us really all that much, but it's not the best way to pull off that play. So a little bit more strategy there would have been wiser. We can actually go into, okay, there's every wrong way to go. We can actually go in here and then undo the damage there. We need to save at least one of these charges for Isaac because we're not in a supremely amazing spot right now. There's a soul heart here. We're gonna make the spikes come after us and then do this. Wow. Double damage upgrade here. We're definitely gonna need to go for these. Stapler as well as glass eye, and then we're just gonna use the fool card to get on out of here. Obviously, those were all stats up here because of Libra, but still, all stats up are great. Almost maxed out our tears rate again on another run here, that's a great place to be in. Also get our third soul heart from that tinted rock, which is good. Absolutely despise this room. Every ounce of my body, I despise that room. The deacons, I wish, just didn't exist. They're so annoying to deal with. Now that the game has heard that I hate that room, then you know that it's going to make us go through that room again. And just be ready for the full clear, because it's coming. Soul Heart for a key. That's a pretty good deal. Like a reverse tinted rock. Maybe not. Fucked out. But yeah, heaping helping of Isaac today, everyone. Hope you appreciated the extra surprise run on you. It's kind of become a little bit of a tradition. We do something a little bit special for Thanksgiving. I mean, again, it is my favorite holiday, so you know, I like putting on a little bit of extra little love into these episodes. Not very happy that we lost our soul heart here. I'm very, very highly considering undoing it. In fact, I'm going to. We can do better than that. This is where having the ads actually works against Isaac because of Sigil of Baphomet. I mean, Sigil of Baphomet is a hard counter to a lot of mechanics because of the way that it works. Charge Baby actually gave us a charge on the Hourglass. And, you know, having the slowing effect from the regular Hourglass, too, that's no big deal. You know, it's nice to have for crowd control and whatnot. Eve's Mascara is exclusively an all stats down. for Libra. There's very few items that are just straight up all stats down, but these mascara is one of them. If you don't believe me, I'll take it after we're done clearing this run and ending it. Take it just for science. Maybe something changed, I don't know. This is where we thank Pink Window for spawning those spiders at the beginning. Oh, you're supposed to be dead, ma'am. There's zero HP on that bar. You are not supposed to be alive. Losing HP in a room that we don't have to be in is unacceptable. Why is Lost so tanky? What is going on? Steam Sale, High Priestess. It's pretty nasty rooms here on the way to, I think is the right way to go. By God. By God. Thanksgiving, by God. What is up with Luss? Why do we keep getting Luss? I don't know why. She's just being a giant pain today. I need to take down Pride here as fast as possible. Super Pride is not terrible, but he is kind of annoying because of the fact of the Mega Troll Bombs. The frequency that sometimes he spawns them in. Thank you, Little Horn, for giving us those three sigil Baphomet shields. I appreciate it. And this has all been for a dead end. All right. How does he do it? How does he do it? If this map doesn't scream Invicta map, I don't know what does. Multiple branching pathways that we've gone to all of them. We're still going. Now I'm getting hungry. Now I'm thinking about all the Thanksgiving stuff that I potentially could be eating by now. What time is it? 108, almost 109? Yeah. I'm picking on the cookies, maybe sneaking a little piece of ham or something. Turkey's probably not done yet, but it's getting there. So thank you for watching, everyone. Like I said, happy Thanksgiving. Hopefully you enjoy this extra episode today in celebration of Thanksgiving. Or again, if you're not in the US and you just don't care, or you just don't celebrate Thanksgiving, I just hope you're having a fantastic start to your Thursday here. Enjoy the evening and the day and football and, you know, or whatever else you got going on for a Thursday, or just video games. You're playing video games. Which games are you playing? You playing Pokemon? Are you hating it as much as I am? I know I am. Before we end, of course, I'm gonna go back and pick up Eve's mascara. Just to show you that, just to give you the PSA on why you shouldn't take Ease Mascara with Libra, as it's not a good idea. Unless, like I said, something changed or not. Okay, it's actually a slight damage. It's actually a slight all stats up, except you lose a lot of shot speed. Maybe that's what I was thinking of. Either way, I prefer not to take Ease Mascara. It's not enough of a good thing. for Libra. But happy Thanksgiving, everyone. Have a great start to your Thursday. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. If you're new here, make sure you click the subscribe button. I really would appreciate it. And also leaving a comment down below and clicking the like button is the best way to support your favorite YouTubers here on YouTube. As always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank the patrons of mine like Riley Cavallari, Sebastian Ayorga, Tyrone Rangers, Henry Kaufman, and Exodus. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.